Once you're done with your track, this is the point where you want to export it and either, you know, share it with someone or upload it for a streaming platform like Spotify or SoundCloud. Now, when doing this, you can always export it as a WAV file or AIFF, but you can also export it as an MP3. So this is the project. And now I want to export it. So I'll click the three dots here, go to File, and then Export Audio. Now, Export Song as Audio, there are a handful of options to choose from. Really, the first thing you want to determine is what type of file. So from here, I can select it as a WAV, AIFF, or as an MP3. Now, for MP3, you can also adjust the sample rate. So I'm just going to leave it as 44:1. And then you can also change the bit depth. Now, depending on which one you select, it's going to change the size of the file. Now, from here, though, you can choose what source you want it to export. You can either export all, so the entire project. So in this case, the source is the master, which is everything. Or you can export group. So it's going to be basically creating stems per group. So it would be an audio file of the main drums, intro, bass, vocal, and so on. Or if you want to export the stems for every single sound slot in every single group, you can always select sound. And within each one, let's say there's certain sounds that you don't actually end up using, you can always uncheck it here and it's not going to export it as the audio file. And the type of audio file, again, is all based upon what you have selected here. Additional options that you have are the ability to normalize the audio, or you can also select something like loop optimize, where let's say you're creating a drum loop and you want it to be a perfect 8 bars. And, you know, maybe one of the sounds has a tail at the end. Loop optimize is basically going to make it so right at bar 8 or however long your pattern is, it's going to stop it so that you can just basically use this for a future project. You can also then split it by section. So if you want to export, you know, stems per scene, you can always select that here. Now, once you've selected and configured all of your export settings here, this is where you would choose where do you want this to be exported to. So by clicking here, you can select the location on your computer, and then this is going to be the naming for your export. And once you've determined all of that, the file type and the location, all you have to do is just click on export.